Do you need to measure impedance and are considering what kind of instrument to use? Today we are comparing LCR meters such as the LCX from Rohde and Schwarz and impedance analyzers such as the MFIA from Zurich Instruments. Hi, I'm Dino Klotz, application scientist at Zurich Instruments. This video will help you choose which type of instrument will suit your specific application. Electrical impedance is the complex AC resistance. It is frequency dependent and can be expressed by inductance, capacitance and resistance, L, C and R. Both LCR meters and impedance analyzers measure the impedance by correlating the voltage excitation and the current response. The difference is, an LCR meter primarily measures impedance at a fixed frequency, while an impedance analyzer measures impedance as a function of frequency, typically displayed in Bode or Nyquist plots. Fast and convenient sweep functionality, along with any additional tools and functions, is reflected in the higher cost of impedance analyzers. Keep in mind, some instruments do offer both capabilities in one. As a first example application, let's take material science. When sweeping the frequency, impedance spectroscopy yields the most detailed information of any electrical characterization. The MFIA is a good choice here, thanks to the advanced Lab1 sweeper function. For component and production testing, or for more advanced measurements such as transformer characterization, you'll typically need to test at one frequency to check if a component passes or if the new development was successful. For such applications, consider an LCR meter such as the LCX. Apart from material science and component production, further applications are component R&D, device characterization, service and quality assurance. Not forgetting that the two instruments are perfect for teaching. Now, consider the measurement parameters for your application. You may need to adjust or even sweep a voltage bias. You can choose up to 40 volts with the LCX, and the MFIA works with up to 10 volts. Do you need a current bias of up to 200 milliamps, or is a current input of 10 milliamps enough? Check if the instrument provides enough range for your purposes. Good instruments provide various hardware connectors such as USB, Ethernet or GPIB, and have API control of common programming languages available. Make sure that it is easy to export the measurement data in your desired file format. Measurement speed is critical for many applications such as transient measurements, sensors and microfluidics. Check if the instrument can measure on a timescale suitable for your application. For materials characterization and component testing, the impedances can become very high. For other applications such as DC link capacitors and shunt characterization, the impedance can become extremely low. Take a look at the detailed specs of the instrument. Both these instruments cover a wide range of impedance from the milliohm to the megaohm regime and beyond, along with a basic accuracy of 0.05%. Remember, it is possible to measure outside the specified range by running a well-defined calibration. Connecting your sample or device requires cables, a specific jig or fixture. Consider if the instrument has suitable fixtures or is compatible with standardized ones. Also, make sure that the instrument can compensate for your setup. Let's wrap up. If you're looking to characterize materials or devices as a function of frequency, then choose an impedance analyzer such as the MFIA. If you're developing or testing component at fixed frequency with a wide voltage and current biasing, then an LCR meter such as the LCX is a smart choice. I hope this video has helped. If you have any questions, please get in touch. We'll be happy to help.